Hey everyone, it's Oats here. I am just updating you from the Oregon fires, but also just to let you know we're still all okay. The fires out here in Oregon are still, well, they're still on fire and still lots of animals being evacuated and moved around and people, so many people have lost so much according to the human and what we keep hearing, you know, from around other bunnies. How do we get our information from other bunnies? We have our ways. Hope you are all doing well in different parts of the world. We know there's other bunnies in the house now that don't belong to us. They belong to people we don't know, but we can hear them there in the other room. They seem to be doing fine. We've been told we can't be around them. We hope everyone's doing well and hope that you're not in one of the places that's on fire. Seems like the whole area's on fire and it smells like smoke 24/7, but humans doing a good job here keeping the smoke and ash out of our house. And we're thankful we're not outside. That's a good thing because lots and lots of animals are stuck outside with all these fires and disasters going on literally on all sides of us. You guys take care and give your bunnies an extra hug today. We all need a little encouragement and hoping this will end soon. Stay healthy and talk to you guys later. Hey everyone, it's Roland. Roland Sims for Tiny. Your friend from Oregon Fire Central, United States of America. The fires are still burning and us bunnies though, we're safe inside. Even though there's a slight smell of smoke in everything. In the first couple days, all the humans around here had a lot of trouble keeping the smoke and ash out of the house, but we're doing better now. Usually we're allowed outside for outdoor playtime, but we haven't been outside for a long time. We're stuck inside for now because it's not safe out there. The air is toxic and hazardous 5 to 8 times, I think, more than humans are supposed to breathe. I don't understand the math of all of it, but it's hazardous and toxic, and I feel all the bunnies here feel bad for the animals that are stuck outside. We can just imagine the coughing of the animals. It sounds like this. that's what it would sound like if animals are coughing, I think. We still have bunnies from evacuees, people we don't know, under the kitchen table and scattered around that the human is taking care of. But every bunny that the human's taking care of right now, they're all safe inside and being well cared for. So if you're in a fire area, hope you're doing okay. And I hope everybody's animals are inside, or if you have outside animals and you're breathing all this smoke, you can do something to cover their enclosures, like put a wet canvas blanket over, just something to protect your animals from the smoke. We heard earlier that lots and lots of animals owners around here whose dogs and cats are vomiting and just getting really sick. So if they're stuck outside, that's my only update. And thanks for stopping in. Hey friends, it's Bandit here, and I just wanted to give you a little update along with some of the other house rabbits here. I feel so sorry for the people evacuating and all the animals stuck outside here in Oregon, where literally it's just fire everywhere and has been for a long time. But here's my question, like, how am I supposed to get my rabbit karate skills classes done, guard the neighborhood from house clowns, yard clowns, and all these things when we can't go outside for outdoor playtime? Like, it's been 2 years since we've been outside. What's that? Oh, the human said no, it's been more like a week. So, I don't know what a week is. Anyway, I hope wherever you are, you guys are staying safe, and we're managing things here. I'm gonna have to redo the schedule for our house rabbit training here and incorporate some of these real-life fire evacuee buns that we have staying with us. They're interested. We're not supposed to go near them, to be clear. Humans got them quarantined, as she would if some rescuer brought her a bunny to foster or take care of here, but I'm gonna do what we can to get them up to speed while not going near them, if that makes any sense. The other thing is, we're all the humans around here and the bunnies, we do our part, you know, as much as we can without going outside. We don't even sneak outside anymore like we used to at night. Well, maybe I shouldn't have said that out loud. The human doesn't know we do that. Well, anyway, the humans are trying to do what they can for the wildlife, keeping fresh water outside. Because there's ash in all the waterways, and ash makes water acidic and can be toxic to the animals, the wild animals that are being driven into our neighborhoods from fires. But I heard the human say something really sad. We have lots of birds around here that she takes care of, and the birds, after the smoke got really, really bad and the fires got really, really bad, they're just all gone. Not seeing many birds fly around, and that's real sad because the hummingbirds were just starting to nest. Anyway, that's the update from here. Still focused on doing what we can for rabbit security and all the things that go on here in Buntown. If you're in a fire zone, stay safe. Talk to you later. Girl, these fires. Down south, we had hurricanes and other big events that threw everybody into a dither. lots of loss of life, loss of homes, but out here, these fires, even though we're not allowed outside, you can smell the smoke. Y'all, it is overwhelming. I am here in the human, just on the phone, trying to coordinate things, gone, working at the fairgrounds. That is the case with all the humans around here. It is all hands on deck. There are so many good people hauling animals out of the fire zones, but there's also so much loss of life from what us buns can gather, the information we're able to get, and it is just the saddest thing. We are all praying for rain, and we are hoping that this all ends soon. But today the fires are still burning, but we are safe here. We are safe here. Please bring your pets inside if you are in a fire zone. We know people who literally have ducks and chickens in their laundry room so that they don't have to smell the smoke. We've got so many bunnies in here that it's a bunny party up in here. It's exciting and fun, but it's also a little bit devastating because we know there is a massive loss of life of animals. Send us your well wishes out here on the west coast of the United States of America, because we are still on fire. Thank you for being here. We love you all.